Yeah, let me get it.
Okay.
Yeah, let me get.
I can start, did everybody see my email that came out today?
That's what I was gonna say.
I didn't have time to read it.
Okay.
I was thinking about the sponsorship letters, and I'd like to change them up a little bit. Not that one, but the cover letter that goes with it. I think we should change that one up a little bit.
Okay.
That one I have not looked at in detail, it was just the one that I looked at.
So Jody had requested that we take the first line of this one out that says the summer rec was almost canceled in the summer of 2017 due to various concerns.
Yeah.
And so then it would start, instead of with that, it would start with, the camps are included in the overall town budget and have been given an annual stipend from the town prior to 2017. The camp frequently under budgeted its needs. The select board asked in 2017 that the program cover its own costs as part of its rebuilding, which we were able to do up to 97% of our total cost. With the majority of the budget, while the majority of the budget comes from camper tuition, there are areas in which we would be able to enhance with additional funds. So that is part of the stuff that changed. The next paragraph stayed the same. And then in the third paragraph on this page, I highlighted three or four sentences. One was just the change of date, that the program begins June 25th instead of June 26th. For 5 days a week, for 8 weeks. And then the next sentence I changed due to age, because it used to be campers entering first grade through eighth grade. And now it says campers range from ages 5 to 12. And it says new in 2018, we will be offering a teen camp with age appropriate activities and trips for campers aged 12 to 15. Teen camp will be 3 days a week over 7 weeks starting June 25th.
Do you have an extra copy of that?
I can circle this one around and we might be able to make copies. And then the next sentence I only added in because there are two camps that we offer arts and crafts, games, field trips, sports, and much more in Camp Raleigh, because I'm not sure all those things are the camp.
This is what the sponsorship is, that's what we're talking about?
Yeah.
I was thinking that we should probably change the first paragraph a little bit, only because we used the same one last year, right?
Yeah, this is.
And I think if we're asking, we're talking about the stipend, I think a lot of people might be saying to themselves, well, if they're getting sort of more, I'm like, you know, money.
So I brought that along, feel free to.
Where's Dan? Where's the English teacher when we need him?
And I do have two copies of the second page. And I added in, I changed the sponsorship levels a little bit because the camp went up in price. And because last year we did have a business give us $120, which is only half of the camper tuition, and we were in a quandary when we received it, what to do with it. So I moved sponsor a camper to the top at $300. And it says for $300 you can cover the tuition for a camper involved in Camp Raleigh ages 5 to 12 who would otherwise be unable to participate in the program. Then the rest of that paragraph is the same. Camp Raleigh Hero is $250, same as last year. And then I added in sponsor a teen, $125. New in 2018, the teen camp for local teen is the teen camp for local teens ages 12 to 15. The teen camp will run 3 days a week for 7 weeks. Each day is planned out with fun activities from rope courses to swimming and amusement parks. Since the camp is filled with so many activities and trips, and or trips, the weekly fee is $125. Your donation to the teen camp will allow a teen to attend, a few days having fun with their peers that would not otherwise happen.
So my whole feeling about this, and just looking, I think business owners, the shorter the better to me.
Bullets.
Yeah. If we can put this on one page somehow, and
this definitely needs to be shown up.
Yeah. And I know you're, I know what you're doing, Celia. You're trying to explain and bring them in, but if we can somehow condense it and make it one page and just be like, I don't know.
Yes, the total cost for somebody like soup to nuts is $380, right? Like registration, bus fee, everything is
$380.
Yeah.
No,
three.
That's 370.
Mm. No.
Right.
It's 330 plus 40.
Yes. So registration. Yeah. 330.
So if you're gonna sponsor one child, then you should say it's $370.
What did we decide about the registration fee?
We waived the registration fee last year.
Okay. So we really
for somebody
that was in need. Yeah. So I didn't think that we were asking for the full.
Yeah.
I wanted to double check. Yeah. So it would be a 330 would probably be the sponsor a camper.
And so last year we had asked the parents, because we were given the option of stay back, so the parents chipped in $5 a week for the bus trips. That's why I left it at $300.
And the bus trips are included.
Right,
in
so we
can't.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So stay back option's gone.
I did not know that, actually. Yeah, I need this. Let me just come out of the packet. I don't think, how many, Brittany, how many kids did we have stay back?
Two different packs. So one time, one the other.
I mean, that's a big expense.
A waste of a counselor.
Yeah, that is. That's a tough one.
So I will pass this over to the previous wordsmith in a few minutes. But there are two different ones because one has our tax ID number on it and one does not, because a couple of businesses want the tax ID number up front. In the how to sponsor, the reason most of it is highlighted was just date changes and stuff. Because I'm waiting for to find out if we can do online registrations.
Can I have that second copy?
That's the copy with the tax ID number. This is the same thing, that's the tax ID number. And Kelly, to answer your question, what we did last year was we double-sided the paper.
Yeah.
So it was one sheet of paper.
Yeah.
They got information on one side, and on the opposite side, they got the how to sponsor.
To fill out, or what the paperwork to fill out?
Yeah. So.
Yeah, I think if we can make it one side with just the information.
And just put the logo on.
I think as short and sweet as you can do it.
And
because most people are going to be kind of like.
Literally, when you're sponsoring, if you're a business, you look at this much.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I would suggest there are two big paragraphs on each of those pages you could take out.
Mm-hmm.
You could take out the paragraph about the shirts and condense that to one sentence. Say, the shirts are made locally, or put that in by a shirt. They're made locally by a graphic artist and printed locally. And you don't need all of the extra stuff there. And then you could take out on the first page the paragraph about how camp promotes community.
Mm-hmm.
We added that last year as a selling point.
Give me a chance to work on it. I could probably get it done by Tuesday.
Okay.
For a draft.
Yeah.
I go to the ladies' auxiliary meeting on Tuesday night.
Okay.
So it's in the evening.
Okay.
Would they like the long form? They'll take anything.
Yeah,
really.
Yep. So. Maybe we should just send that to them and say, hey,
I've done
this letter.
I've done sponsorship letters for other nonprofits, so I can.
Yeah.
I'll just tighten it up a little bit.
and basically what I did, took what we had last year, what we had approved, mm-hmm. changed dates, and added in a little bit of information about the teen camp, because it was new.
Yeah, and I think that's great. I mean, Dee's been interested in doing this. Like, you can do sponsor camp rally and new, you know, mm-hmm. teen camp or something, you know.
I shall do it. Quick question. Are we still making checks out to Tom Rollins? Right? Okay,
yes.
So we another round check. Or will we ever, do you think?
Will you ever change that? No. not while you're under the umbrella of the town.
Okay.
Who does the, if they are giving you a check now, who did they make it up to?
Tom Rollins.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And just put
Camp Rollins in the
umbrella.
Well, I wonder was there any, I don't know if we want to change or talk about how we decided, was it first come, first serve? Is that kind of how we did it last year?
It was first come, first serve, and they had to provide last year's tax returns.
Yeah.
Last year's tax returns or 2 months of pay stubs. So we could put them in a financial category like my work does.
Yeah.
And then if they fell below the 250 poverty line, then they qualify.
Okay.
So last year we had folks contact you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the same, do you want to, or do you want to do
whatever? That's
a
select board, because they'll be coming in after the election's over, and then I will no longer be a selectman. Mm-hmm. So where it's my realm that I work with in public health, and I know how they do that, I don't think they would allow me to know the camper at that point, but we have to know the camper at that point because we need to know if we're collecting payment or not. So I'll ask them.
Are we going to publicize that we have scholarships available? We didn't last year.
We didn't? I thought we
did.
No.
We didn't?
Okay.
Not till the very end.
Okay.
Like, end of May, I think it was. I can check the letters.
We didn't want to really be
excited. Yeah.
With people asking for money that we didn't have.
Right.
And
but, I mean, in that case, I don't think it hurts to take information. If we don't have money to give, we don't have money to give. But, I mean, that's... I mean, or, you know, if we want people to, if it's first come, first serve, it's kind of like, if there's a need and we have money, you know, it could be like a wait list type of thing.
Well, we didn't advertise it last year, and we still received a couple of requests.
Right.
I think it was maybe word of mouth or somebody asked.
I think we put it on Facebook at the, like,
towards
as we were getting close to camp.
And I put on there that we wanted all of the donations in by June 1st. Last year we got a couple after that, but June 1st would give us a couple weeks before camp starts. And I don't know when registration is. So there might be a window of time between when we get these, when we're requesting the donations in and when registration closes.
So, maybe just hold off a little while and advertising and we'll see. Yeah, it seems like people always ask if there's a need.
Maybe we see what we have and then maybe beginning of May.
That's probably a good idea. So maybe people are holding off on registering because they don't have the money, so then if they see that they do have a few dollars for that, to let it be known at that point in time.
So check back in on that. One other question about the letter. If you wordsmith it, can it be voted on and be ready for town meeting, or do we have to meet in person and take the vote?
I don't care. I don't need the wordsmith. I don't need to.
So
I
can
the wordsmith thing.
So
the numbers are fine. It's just the wordsmith thing, so I'm fine with it.
Yeah, I don't think we need to.
If there's a spelling error, they'll assume it's me.
Dollar.
We know Dan didn't look at it. So I was just hoping that since we're having a table at town meeting and one for voting day, people had approached us last year about donating, that we could have some of these out, people could pick them up, and then they can send their check right in. If they want to remain anonymous, then we might actually get those people that talked about it last year but never committed to.
Yeah, it'd be great. It'd be great to have this.
Yeah. And then people could, and if we don't need to vote on it, because then we should let her.
Maybe send it to Dan.
Yep.
Dan, you missed the meeting, but we have work
make
for you.
Make it short and sweet. All right,
so we'll have us for Tommy. We'll bring the donation button in, too.
Coffee
Tuesday the
13th. Coffee for town, like, to vote on here? Can we sell coffee here?
You can if you have somebody standing out there, yeah. In the hallway.
Yeah.
We can have a...
Probably not as much as for town.
There's
meeting.
A big rush at 7 a.m.
Okay, count me out.
And then it's very quiet up until 4. And then between 4 and 7, it's really, well, 4 or 4:30, and then it's really busy. On the longest one we had, at the end of the night, we had lines going this way and then back up. So the hallway was full all the way, because to keep them out of the cold.
Yeah.
And so me and Mike were out there directing traffic.
Huh?
And we did, it felt like an airline. We're
yeah.
like, okay. Over this way is new. These people are about to go in. Anybody's a new voter, raise your hand.
You talking about doing a fundraiser?
Well, I was just kind of thinking, like,
it's on our list. We talked about it in January, 4 dates being at the school for their meeting that we were at already, the budget committee meeting, or the town budget, which was for 10. Then being here for voting and then being at the school again for the actual town meeting day.
You know what would be good, but I don't know that you can't whip this together, but in the future, like for 4 to 7, you could sell buckets of chili and rice. That's dinner. You could take dinner home with you from the yeah. That's what we did today.
Well, we had nobody manning the table for donuts and cookies and whatever.
Oh no.
And there was a bucket.
Yeah.
And so that was fine. Like
have people just put in stuff.
Well, the kid was here with the dad, and the kid's like, I want a donut, so the dad gave him a 5. Well, no one was there at the table, so he put the 5 in, grabbed the donut, went back to the dad. The dad's like, where's my change? He's like, there was no one there. So he made extra 5 bucks.
I thought that was
going to
be a sour story, like somebody took the bucket of money or something.
No. I can be there on the 17th. Does anyone else want to volunteer to help at the table?
I'll be there on the 17th.
That's a town meeting, right?
Yeah. We should be selling green beer that day. It's really what we should do.
That would go over
corn
much better.
Hash.
Yes.
Can't
do that at school.
No?
But it's not school time.
Right.
Can't have that on the property.
Oh, well, then we're moving it to the Legion.
I would
say. Okay, I love it. We would have a lot more fun at that meeting.
Right.
Dee,
I will be there, but I'm not sure how much help I will be.
Okay.
I have my whole day cleared.
My 2 work.
Did I tell you I have help?
Do I have help?
Yeah, Caroline's daughter's doing it.
Oh, cool. I didn't have.
And you might have one more
Shana.
Pickle of the pickle.
Beautiful.
Shana just sent me a
Oh,
email.
She's right there.
Yeah. So maybe she can talk about it.
So sorry about that, everybody.
Come on in.
Quite a drawing.
I just read it, so I didn't read it out loud.
All right.
Would you like me to read it or you just want to tell us?
I can just tell you.
Let's see.
Here, I got it.
And moms, we all know how to do things with one arm.
We have that many.
It probably depends on how many gift cards you actually collect,
okay.
Right? So, this one, it has, there's one on some days, but there's two on other days. Yeah, they, right. So, if like this one that has two, there's one at $20 to Dustin's and $15 to Madison's Cafe. So,
So I guess
really we can do whatever we want to do with whatever we have.
Our next meeting is Tuesday. And I know that we had already discussed voting this in, so we already decided that yes, we would definitely. We were lucky enough, Kate was there, and the other people to help us walk through that. So we definitely are in. We want to help you guys. Caroline is going to do the calendar. How many were we looking at for each kid? Or possibly potentially the seven?
We said that's
ten.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't want a town committee to make a school choice.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's another question I just
came
out. So
I think if we can have incentives, that's a lot of times there's incentives for kids.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think, has anybody else got a bought so many of these calendars and I'm trying to remember what they give for gifts. If you sell the most calendars you get
earplugs at the pizza party.
Yeah, or something like that.
Well,
that's a good idea.
Yeah, I'd love that.
Like to do a class little class competition, which class sells
usually
the most.
What they do.
Yeah.
I've seen
okay.
That,
So maybe just put it that way. Lori, you have a good idea about that.
It's a lot of
education classes. But I also, and you know more about this than I would, they do it by family though, not by students.
Well, so I've had to sell a bunch of these for different sports fundraisers. And if you can say we would love to see every kid sell 10 is usually what they do, but you're gonna get some kids who sell 15 and you're gonna get some kids that sell 3. I don't, the idea is to get as many kids to sell as many as they can, but I hate it when, coaches and stuff that look at me and say, you need to sell 10, and I'm like, ugh.
Yeah.
But so, I think if we can try and do more of an incentive to class competition, that will get more kids involved. and maybe just see ideas. We would love to see if at least every kid sell 10, but there's no... Because really, if you get all of these things donated, which is the idea, you know, anything that comes back, it just,
there are a couple of the teachers, I know Celia was there, that were there, had already said that they have, like, a plethora, an abundance of gift cards that they're more than willing to donate on hand.
That's awesome.
So that's great, because that gets us, you know, already started. The other question is, obviously, when do you want us to start, and deadline?
Well, I think we've all talked about we want this to be done in April, right?
April.
So have the April, so we want this April calendar. So I would say, you know, as soon as you guys meet on Tuesday to get start the collection, you know, you might want to have the kids. We can do, because we'll have March, right? It'll be all in March.
All of March, yeah.
Vacations the 16th to the 21st,
right,
April.
Say that again.
Vacation.
But that's okay. You know, we've actually sold calendars where they pick the winners over vacation. It doesn't matter. You're still gonna get the gift card, and we can put it on the PTO Facebook page, the winners every day, even.
And then that we will be having a new social media person to help us coordinate all of that to keep that on track.
Yeah.
That is hard to sometimes navigate. And that hopefully will be in place on Tuesday.
I think if you can get, you know, take the next 2 weeks to get the donations in, and then give the kids 2 weeks to sell,
I think that's the timing.
And then, so you want to have everything in, all the calendars in by Friday, the 30th of March, all the money. And then they start picking on, you know, and they do Sunday too. So
that's great. Yeah. Okay.
So does that sound good? Does everybody sound good about this?
What is the cost on the calendar?
They're usually $10.
Yeah.
What question are we going to make, and what question going to PTO?
I don't know if we talked about that.
I read the text message that you had sent to Billy. And I think what was discussed was like a 50-50 split of the profit. So if I remember correctly, do you remember about the meeting?
Yeah, the PTO had said that they might want to take in all the money and make a donation.
Well, we have to place it as a donation. We can't say, oh, we're going to take all this money and then only give you, like, it has to be stated as a donation. So that's kind of what the wording of that was. Thank you.
So you said you were going to take in and give up a certain amount.
Donate.
Up to 50% or something.
Okay, that makes sense. Maybe that's what was.
Do you guys have anything that you're trying to raise money for right now, like in particular?
Just going to bring that up. The 14th, we're hoping the 14th is going to be our next Ice Cream Social, like our next big event.
Yep.
So this next meeting, we'll be discussing that. We'd like to do the same thing we did last year with the committees coming and having the opportunity to get the word out. There will be more time for more advertising this year than there was last year. So hopefully that'll. I like the timing of this.
Because yours is in April. Mm-hmm. You mean April 14th?
Yeah, we're trying to do it the weekend before spring break.
Yeah.
Just because I know after spring break is when a lot of sports really start picking up.
Last year, was so sure.
Yeah,
you guys were there last year. Yeah. So what, Jana, I was gonna say is the PTO, are you guys trying to, like, do you have a project in mind that you're raising money for? Is there anything?
The project that we discussed at the beginning of the year, and is going to be an ongoing thing for a few years, is that we'd like to get a marquee for the school. Something that matches the school, because we know that it's a historic site, so we'd like to have something fun in front that we can make announcements on and send a million signs all over the lawn.
Oh, okay.
So we're supposed to have a design in place for that by the end of the year.
That's outside?
Yeah.
Nice. You have,
want these to, I would say have these also by March.
Yeah.
Or not,
end
March,
of March,
sorry.
Yeah, right. So money in
middle
of
March.
Money
in
middle
of March, and then so by the last day of March.
So
yeah.
Would
they be available for the 13th parade for to the outside?
Ooh, that's a
and
great idea. 17th? Can we get that down? Well, it all depends. We'd have to have,
the
maybe not the 13th, maybe the 17th. So I think if you guys meet on Tuesday, it's like the get them done.
Mm-hmm. Get the word out. We can actually get the word out on Wednesday if everything's set in stone Tuesday night, and then that'll help speed up the process. If you guys are looking, especially to have student relations everything in by say the 16th.
So, yeah.
16th,
so
we have everything in, and that gives us. The 16th, give it to
the kids on the 19th,
mm-hmm.
maybe, and then ask to have everything turned in by the 30th.
Yeah.
That would be great. And then, yeah, so you'll just have to figure out, like, you know, on the 16th, you know, how many cards you get and
mm-hmm.
what else is in there, and then.
Can we get a stock for the table on the 17th?
Yeah, so as they come in, you know, we can kind of just figure it out when they come in. Kathy, how many hairdressers do you know? Because there's a lot on here, like stuff like that. There's a beauty products gift basket. There's, looks like Isadora's pretty big there. Wellness massage.
So is that what we still need? Is like to solicit for more donations, or do you have plenty of donations already?
That's what I believe is happening. We have a lot of donations that are going to be, like, a lot of them are going to
So maybe if
filling it is our objective.
Right.
Whoever's left.
So maybe if you get an idea, if you put this out to the teachers and everything, like on Tuesday or Wednesday or whatever, and you get back by Friday, maybe you and I can touch base and I can let these guys know if we need to kind of do some. Yeah. Yeah.
I see the donations coming in pretty quick.
Okay.
My concern was about reiterating and expressing data because we don't want to be asking our donors for stuff now and then and giving them our sponsorship money.
Right. Right.
Right.
So
that's why
it's great that
right.
they're taking care of this and that maybe we won't have that,
that does,
overlap.
Yeah, that keeps the lines from being blurred with that too, because then it's coming from the school PTO and you guys can still do your separate fundraising outside of that.
Right.
And can we, as a group, get a stack if we want to sell them? Like if we don't have any kids at school.
I don't see why not. I mean,
absolutely.
Yeah.
You want my stack?
Yeah.
Because I have 30.
You're gonna hold a lot. Some with me or with, I'm sure with Caroline for staff too.
Yeah.
A lot of times we get ignored and they don't need
you
stuff for
do?
Us.
You do.
And then we have to go searching for somebody if we want to buy something.
Yeah.
So,
is that on the PTO side or? The
anybody.
You.
Sometimes it just gets put in. Classroom mailboxes for the classroom, but not for the staff. Sometimes we get
and honestly, that's what we're working with. Like, we're trying to pull everything back together this year and get the funds. So I apologize if the slow moving process.
do this pay offline, I can tell them to activate that, but then we're chasing money. Now, on
we might be anyways.
Right. Well, the payment plan is attached to their credit card or their bank account,
uh-huh.
and it's automatically drawn on a certain day.
Oh, I like
so
that.
So whether they leave camp or not, we're paid. We get our money. I'm like, can they finagle out of this? Do they have an opt-out if they don't want to come back? If they said no. So this was pre-camp. And then this is the 2 weeks that I put one of the kids in. So I can either pay in full or I can schedule payment options. Now here's where the problem was. I thought it could do the week that, you know, they went. Well, they can't do that week. They can just schedule it weekly payments or bi-weekly payments or whenever we told them to. But if you picked week 2 and 6, it's not going to bill you on 2 and 6. That's what I thought it could do, and it couldn't. So what it does is instead of the 8 payments that we thought we could do, I shrunk them down to 4. So all of our money would be in by the July 23rd of the year. So they're still coming 8 weeks later. So they're only coming for the first 2 weeks of camp, and they have to pay $40 now, because that was the minimum. And then their credit card is going to be billed $20 on the 18th, $20 on the 25th, $20 on the 16th, and $20 on the 23rd. And then the fee was waived for the second child, obviously, so there's your discount for the family.
Yep.
And then this child, I put in, this is Zach, I put in as he's coming all 8 weeks, he's the whole summer off. You can either pay in full or schedule payments. Now, when I schedule his payment, his minimum charge on registration day is $20, and then he's going to have $7.50 taken out.
So just divides it by in 4?
Divided by 4. Yeah. So then here's your registration fee for the first child.
Yeah.
And that's not an option. We have to pay that in full.
Yeah.
So now their total for when they registered was $189. Their total due when summer's over is going to be $579. But right now they only have to come up with $189. And in a couple of weeks they're going to have to come up with $77 for this kid and $20 for that kid.
Okay. But it automatically comes out of their account.
Yeah, automatically comes out of their account and goes right into our checking account. I think once a week, he said. So that's how it worked out. So the processing fee is, I think, 1 or 2%. I forgot what it said.
Well, really? Because when I did it today, so I put in for 3 kids today,
mm-hmm.
and they'll tell you all the things. But my bill came up to like $1,000, and I did different. I said pay in full now, and it was like a $33 processing fee.
Oh, wow.
So that's 3.4% is what I figured out.
Because each one of these that is charged out is 3%. So if you look at mine right now, I have a $29 processing fee.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to have so many charges.
Right.
So, but if you paid it all in full,
yeah,
you should have had. So let me change this
because I figured out the percentage. It was like 3.4%.
So this was a 3%. This was a 3%. It looks at it as an item. Each item is 3%. When you're registering for softball, it's only one season, and it's only 1.3%.
Right.
But each of these, they looked at as a quantity. So each of those is a separate item that gets billed.
Is this the Jeffers only choice?
No, they can do paper.
They can do paper, okay.
Are they willing to negotiate with you as far as processing fees?
I didn't ask that.
That's a lot.
So
because if we talk about
we asked them to do so much,
yeah.
and to divide it out so
so many ways. This is like 3 and 4 or 5 phone conversations.
Right.
I'm like, oh, I don't want to go live until I talk to the group.
Yeah.
So Jody, when you did your 2 kids, did you do camp rally?
Mm-hmm.
It was just camp rally. So what I did 2 kids camp rally and then 1 kid teen camp. So, and honestly, I couldn't remember what we decided as a group, but I think it did something that we didn't want it to do. Although I didn't mind, but it actually waived. And I don't think we agreed on this. It waived my fee for my 1 kid in teen camp for the registration fee.
I think we didn't agree on that, but I'm okay with it if the group's okay with that.
So one family fee is basically what you're saying.
Yeah.
For $4.
Because how many families are we going to have that are going to have both camps? There's only 2, 3. You know, for chasing down the money, we're going into our checking account and we're not chasing families. I think the cost benefits outweigh themselves. So,
okay. So
if everybody else is okay,
I just didn't know. So that was one of the things, I didn't know if that was a glitch or not. So
yeah, no, because well, once again, it couldn't. We're asking it to do 2 separate camps,
yeah.
And then I said, no, it's a discount for the families, and then they're like, oh, I don't think so. Like, I'm sure, like, processing it, they probably could have figured it out, but, you know, at this point, I'm afraid they're going to charge us more than $200.
Right.
So, if I put one of them into teen camp, residents, I'm going to teen camp.
Well, that was a little confusing to a payment session.
So this is the weeks that you're picking, and then this was the payment sessions that you're picking. Why they did that,
That's so weird.
Yeah. Because it's one of those prompts, like you're prompting teen camp, and then you're picking your week, and then you're picking your...
Mm-hmm.
So,
I mean, it was fine.
So
it just was kind of like, oh, do I have to do this too?
So if you don't click registration, will it let you go past
it?
No,
it won't let you go past it.
So while you have this up, Jody.
Yeah.
This was another one of my questions. So there's no way, or I couldn't figure out, to check those boxes on the on our waivers.
Yes, I saw that too. They'll just have to tell them if they don't want a photographer. Because these, they just cut and paste it from our paperwork.
Right. Well, so I was kind of like, oh, I can't click on any of those to do.
Right. Right here, your electronic signature just said that I have read and understand.
Right.
So, and then if they don't want their kid to be photographed, then they would have to let us know otherwise.
Can we make
Because it's pretty, so that was all my questions were basically on stuff like that. So there's a consent form that was, there it is right there. So there's like 5 consents there,
mm-hmm.
that there's no way to check anything, like authorization to view G movies, authorization to view GPG movies. So
you want checks for all of these?
There should be some way to acknowledge. Or even could we do a yes no answer on those following? I don't know.
Not.
So if we're gonna
so
do
you
that,
want a yes no and an electronic signature.
Well, you still want the signature, so I like how that was in there.
Yeah.
But so on everything we basically, so even on the permission waiver too, like it says check 1 right there. Can there be a box there that says is yes?
Well, not right now because all they did was cut and paste it. So they can, if I can ask them to go back and rewrite it. And
can they put it at the bottom? Like underneath it?
Right, or they can.
So that they can.
Oh, so you say like
take
this,
that and.
And then put it down here.
Yeah.
I click permission, or I do not give permission, and then I sign the electronic waiver.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe something like
okay.
that.
If they do that.
And then, so that was the thing on the consent form, too. Like you're saying, authorization to apply sunscreen. That needs to be like a yes, no. Authorization to view G movies only. Yes, no. Authorization to view PG, PG, and off-site walks. So we need some way of yes, no on that.
Yes, no's on here? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then what else did I have here? Just a glitch, but on the so every kid that I put in where it said pick up permission people, so every kid I had to
yes
refill that in.
Yes. And their insurance and their phone numbers and my phone number.
Yeah, but at least once you put it in once, it then you can click on it, though it comes up once you start to go do it again. So
no,
when
you go to another computer.
Oh, sorry.
I did part of it at work and then I did the other
yeah.
part at home and I'm like, oh.
Oh, and the other one was the medical, there's a medical treatment form. I don't know if that was before that or after it, and that was another thing that we couldn't click on.
It had their picture though, wasn't it?
Yeah, so here.
After insurance.
Yeah, here one of them, they wanted the physician's home phone.
Yeah.
I'm like,
No, I don't need
the home phone. And so these are all options now.
Yeah.
They were mandatory before, they're now options.
Right, so right there they have a drop down yes or no option that you could use for the other screen.
Right, does the player have any?
Oh, right here?
Yeah.
Well, and, yeah.
Or even or down below where it is like the yes no, so they should.
Right here.
To,
yeah,
they should
yeah.
be able to break that off.
But there's somewhere medical treatment, I think it says we give our areas, so you couldn't put anything in those spaces, but I don't know if we really, maybe it did.
Well, now you don't have to because it's all written above.
Right, right. So just do the electronic signature?
Right, up above,
okay.
It tells you who your physicians are, who your
right.
insurance is, who your emergency contacts are,
right.
and who your primary contacts are.
Okay.
So
that one we
that
don't
one
need.
I didn't.
Yeah.
And then if you do have medications, it won't let you go any further, or if you do have a condition, you have to write Copeland. And if I skip any of these with the red asterisk, it won't let me continue. So they need to know he has 10 milligrams once a day, and taken during program hours, nothing. Duration of program, nothing. Possible side effects, none. You have to fill it all out if you put yes.
Did you guys make a decision that you're not taking any T1s or anybody again this year?
We haven't talked about it.
Oh, okay.
T1s?
Type 1 diabetes.
Oh. I mean, last year ended up being fine. We managed it, but she also had one of the newer systems where we could see on our phones where she was at, so she wouldn't have to tell us. I mean, it worked out fine.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how everybody else feels.
I don't think you can say no.
Right?
Yeah,
I think that was
part of the discrimination, and I don't think. Is there the nurse? Is the nurse at school all day? Or?
The nurse. We don't have a nurse on staff,
right.
So there's
that's
an issue.
That's
about
right.
Yeah.
I talked to Gail about it. Gail was kind of like,
right.
She was like,
we
don't have
us.
I think we had a conversation with both parents about it. Like, you know, this is going to be on you. And they weren't allowed to, right? You guys were not allowed to administer. Yeah,
she
had an older sister there that did all the injections and stuff.
I totally agree with you. It's a discrimination, but, you know, that's
I just so much more conscious.
I just know there's so much with that ID and the laws and stuff. That,
so, from what I remember from last year, what we discussed was we couldn't discriminate based on a condition,
mm-hmm.
but we could request that the family
family provide the needed support, mm-hmm. whether it be somebody else to give the medication, the parents come with the kid if they're going on a field trip, or they send somebody that can provide mm-hmm. the necessary assistance to that mm-hmm. child.
And our first aid kits had frosting and glucose tablets and things like that if they needed it. So. And they were trained on how to use it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, parents came in and told us how to use all the stuff that she had. So.
Mm-hmm. I'm just curious from last year.
Do you know if they're coming back? They were some foreign people.
I don't
wonder.
Know. I know they left halfway through the summer. I think they weren't there the entire time. They went out somewhere.
Yeah, I think they were on vacation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're great. I love them.
Yeah. They're good family.
I did like the fact, like, I know paying in full was the discount, mm-hmm. but I do like the fact that you don't have to come up with that $330 all at once. Mm-hmm. I'm wondering if we're going to get more people, and then we're still going to have the people that only come 2 or 3 weeks.
I think we talked about that too. So last time we thought we'd probably get more campers if the parents didn't have to pay for everything.
Right. So
I have a parent come up to me and ask me a couple of questions.
And pay by credit card, which you couldn't. I'm sorry.
She is only sending her kids 2 days a week. She's going to pay for the whole summer. She's going to drop off a check later this month. She sent the social registration. So. But she wanted to know, pre-care, can she do just 2 days a week for pre-care? Does she have to do every day if her kids are only coming those 2 days? Because they dropped off at 8:30 those 2 days or not? Does she? And then one of her other concerns is she has 2 kids, one gets car sick and cannot travel far on a bus. So does that child have to be on the bus? Or can she, if it's a day that they wouldn't normally be there, but they want to go on the field trip, can she provide the transportation for the child?
Like she goes on the field trip?
Like she would follow the bus in her vehicle.
Was there not something about insurance when it comes to the children needs to be?
The children need to be on the bus unless they're with their parent. If their parent wants to bring them, we can't stop a parent from bringing them.
Right, but then
so
they wouldn't technically be coming with us that day.
Right, and then they'd have to pay their own entrance to the park.
The mom would have to stay with them, because technically then the mom is with them.
Right.
It's not a drop-off situation.
Right. Because if they're not on the bus, they don't count.
Yep.
Like, if any counselor follows behind them, you guys have to pay your own way.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you squeeze as many people as you can.
And if they're only coming 2 days a week,
that's
her choice. How does she fill that out on the paperwork?
She needs pre and post care on those weeks, and she pays it.
Is there, I don't know anything, is there like a note section on there at all? Mm-hmm. That if parents have something that they want you to know that's not necessarily part of our paperwork, that they can just write a little thing?
I believe there was.
Yeah.
I'd have to find it, but... What do you mean by
like anything like
because there's
my
so like
car sick
yeah
just so you know kind of stuff
well yeah. That would go under anything under medical
right
so
but what about like a fear of like my kids don't like heights don't let them go on water slides
yeah or thunder or
yeah
no way it's documented
because
you know they're gonna come up and tell you everything
right
like, oh okay here's the next person gonna
yeah,
maybe like somewhere at the end, you have anything else we should know about your child or something.
I think it is in medical.
And that was her other question, is how comfortable does the director or the staff feel her other child, not the one that gets cursed, but the second child she's saying that has sensory issues. Are you willing to, like, it would be under the medical stuff. But
that
like,
has to be under medical.
Would you be willing to, like, give them headphones or whatever they needed.
If they bring them, I'm not going to go out and buy
school
stuff
that have them and they bring them.
Right.
Yeah.
And my student was not, had no issues with thunder, but there was a little girl there who did, and he knew it until it started thundering there and she freaked out.
Any weird little quirks helps us be more prepared. If I don't know that a kid doesn't like heights and they try going on a slide and then they stand there for 20 minutes, I'm blindsided by that and I kind of go into panic mode a little bit, like how do I calm this kid down kind of stuff. So.
Oh, the other thing was the garden club wanted to put a beehive next to the stage. So, I know, my daughter is, even though it's a honeybee, is just afraid of bees because she got stung when she was little. And next to the stage, I was very surprised, but that's where they wanted to put it. So I felt uncomfortable. If they are going to put it there, I would recommend not going to the garden any longer. But I said I would bring it back to you guys, so I bring it back to them tomorrow. So how do we feel about that?
Yeah, I'm not comfortable with going to the garden. That's just me, though.
You don't know, like, who, some kids might have knowledge and they didn't know it.
Right.
You know, and they see a bee and they, some kids, like, are very overreactive. Like, my kid right now is overacting everything, you know. So then he's like going like this, and then he missed all the bees upset, and somebody gets stung, and
yeah. You know, that might be a day of split group. I mean, there might be kids who don't care.
Yeah.
Like, maybe you take half, you know, I don't know what the day is or whatever. But half
girl
can go there.
Yeah.
Those
but then you
not necessarily liking
surprise.
Bees don't go there.
I do not suggest sending my children there. Zoe will be afraid. Zach will be poking at.
Are they going to do some kind of teaching thing about the bees or something with the school? They said, I don't know if they will
hurt
anything.
But
they're in the process of setting something up, and they wanted to know who would like to do it with the kids.
Just a simple
thing. How many bees sting?
I don't know. Like in all the cartoons, they've seen the bees, right?
Is it just the yellow jacket?
Let's see.
Google.
Last summer there was, I don't know what kind of bug insect thing, but there was so many homes on the field of the softball, and there were kids that would refuse to play kickball with us because there were bugs flying around.
A honeybee stings a person. Cannot pull the barb stinger back out.
Ooh.
It leaves behind the barb. This is what happened to me when I was pregnant and swimming.
Does it
I stepped
die?
On it, and that thing was pulsating.
Really?
Like, just the butt was in my, like, the stinger was in, and the butt was sitting there, and it was pulsating the stuff in my foot. It was bananas. Yeah, we can't have it just clean.
Jody, with the changes that we need to make, when do you think that, when can we get another iteration of it?
Female bees are the only ones that sting.
If they contact
them, that's right away.
I got a name for them.
Phoning them seems to be the only way to get them
to
respond to me.
Okay.
Luckily, I did get them.
I think that's a good idea.
Because if you look on their website, they have a phone number.
Yeah.
Their online chat is an email that you send them. I'm like, that's not online chat.
So when, what's today, the 4th? When do you guys want to shoot for? Getting everything out, maybe
so
by next Monday. I think we could probably open up registration.
If they can get these corrections to me tomorrow, I'm on the slope.
That's okay. I still need to have it somewhere.
So,
and copy.
Yeah, are you okay with the payment plan options for both now?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. And pre and post all those. Things you're fine with.
In the pre-post is paying in full.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. That we did that last year, right? Anyways.
Everything was paying in full anyway.
Yeah. So let me just go back over.
So we can't you can't pick like weeks for pre and post week 1, 4, and 7.
You can.
Oh. Okay.
But you have to pay it in full at registration time.
Mm-hmm. It can't be part of the payment plan.
Okay. But
yeah.
But you can
but
still
you
only
can.
Pay for like three weeks of it.
Yeah.
Okay. So I was thinking that.
But
the amount to you had to pay for the whole summer.
Nope.
No, okay. Oh, I think
you
that's
were asking
fine.
If they could pay for just 2 days of it.
No, we don't do that.
No.
This is hard.
charging the same amount for pre-care, even though we had extended it a half hour? Is that true?
So for the folks,
yes, 30 minutes, 7:30. 7:30 to 9, and then 25. So that's something
so stuff for the folks who are now doing, you know, do the paper registration, are we going to offer them the paper registration?
No.
Because we have no way to track it.
I know. That's
they can go online. And that's the whole point of going online and having a credit card option. So
we have to. There's no way we would be able to.
We couldn't track it last year.
I think we should strongly encourage traffic.
Right. You can now pay with a credit card.
Yeah.
Now you can pay in payments. It goes right into the
schedule.
Right.
So once you schedule it, it hooks up to
the. So I might even say, I'll have these done on hand. I'm almost reluctant to not even distribute them and just encourage that
traffic. I definitely want a paper option because I hate processing fees. Like, I would want to pay, it's like when I pay my kids' school for lunch. Like there's a $20 processing fee that is $2.50.
I
something
that drives me crazy.
Like cash. I didn't know that you could do that. Next year I'll give you my. I pay for it all at once, so it's not But yeah, I don't like processing.
I don't like me.
So I would want. I still want that. I still want that choice to pay it in front of all
so
of them.
So you can do that. I want to clarify because there was a couple of conversations going on.
Mm-hmm.
Paper applications are paid in full. At the time of registration for all your weeks, so that way you can track it?
I think so. I think, so.
I think
if we're paying in full, we should do like what we did last year, right? So if you're going to get the
like
discount,
that
section, right? Did we say May 31st was the early bird?
May 12th.
Well, we had two prices. Did we decide not to do that?
If we
did
do that
after a certain time.
No, we didn't do that.
We didn't add any money.
No, what we're doing was the weekly option versus the full 8 weeks. So if you want the full 8 weeks, there's a little discount built in.
So what is our deadline for registration?
That was one of my questions. Last year was June 12th.
It starts June 24th.
We're 25th this year.
That's a good time.
Yeah. So should we have paid in full by June 12th? Registration closes and paid in full by June 12th.
See, I think we pulled in.
We did.
We pulled in some money by just having two different rates there, and given our budget.
Well, but it was only a $20 difference.
25.
Did you wait until June 18th, and then people could be like, oh, I'm going to get paid then, at 15th?
June what?
Well, she said it's June 12th.
Last year we had June 12th, so we need to have. So what I was talking to Dee about,
yeah,
we had early bird.
Wow,
Jody, were we gonna do early bird pricing versus?
Well, that was the whole thing. That if they paid in full, they were early bird, and now the computer can split it up.
Right.
So
that doesn't matter. So the people who are sending in their checks, they're going to have June whatever for a deadline?
Mm-hmm.
What do we want to make that? What is our registration? What are we thinking about our registration deadline?
So it was June 12th last year. So
what day do you want the computer to close? The computer can close whenever you want it to.
Mm.
early bird option is not currently listed because it's being replaced by the whole summer discount versus the weekly payment plan. Is that correct?
Yeah, now a payment plan option.
Yeah.
Okay. I think a lot of people find it easier to come up with $20 a week or whatever it is.
Yeah. Your question is, when is the computer close?
Right. You can, yeah, you just got to give me a date. You want to say the 15th?
That's what Liberty said.
No, I was saying, I'm just mentioning it for some people. They're going to put out $400 of money. You know, they might want to wait till they're paid, like not before, 2 days before payday. Some people have paycheck to paycheck.
So is the 15th a Friday?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's the 15th then.
And that gives us 10 days.
Enough time, Brittany?
And maybe post the computer down. And if we have people who want to register after, if we can go paper for them.
I think that's a good idea.
Or should we keep the word online registration open just in case?
Do I move to the 22nd?
Yeah, let's do that.
Actually,
we're talking about people. When do we shut off registration? Online.
I think, yeah, that we should do the, I like the 15th. I think we need time in case, like what happened last year at the end of the year, did we get quite a few people that last week that registered. So if there's a staffing issue, I don't think we can close it on the 22nd if we then need to hire another counselor.
So close it on the 15th.
Yeah.
Right, we're closing on the 15th.
And then I can always manually add them as an administrator if they desperately need a payment plan or whatever.
Right. Okay.
What about you?
I think that is.
I'd say anybody late like that needs to be in full. Oh, and the auditor was talking about a cash register for not only us but the transfer station. And I'm like, well, this year we're only going to be doing like popsicles and stuff. Nothing. There's not much more else other than the pizza every other week. So let's.
Do we have that as an added, by the way? You know how we're talking about doing the camp cash up front? We're doing that the next time? Can we do that on here too? The parent wants to give $40 or something at the beginning of summer, or is that something we're just going to do manually?
Good question.
That the processing fee.
Right.
Yeah.
You're going to have a processing fee, and it goes directly to the town checking account. So they're not going to be able to make change.
So what if we offer our
I didn't think we were making change. I thought it was going to be like an index card of just subtracting. I didn't think we were doing anything.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
For that part,
yeah.
But then.
Then you're always going to have that.
Right at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
And that last week. When
the money runs out and there's only a week left, you're going to send him with a buck.
So are you talking about just doing it like we did last year as opposed to?
Oh, no, I like the index.
Okay.
No, I was
but
just
that
thinking
seems
about
like a separate
the
issue.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright.
So can you, somebody explain these?
So each kid is going to have an index card with their name on it, their balance for snacks, and then it would just be subtracted off until it hits zero. And let the parents know to refill it, whatever.
And will you let us know?
I'm thinking like when it gets to $5 or $2, I'll let parents know.
Okay. So I'm going to put this in the packet because there's a can of concessions. And we're doing pizza every other week now, on Wednesday, or?
Yeah. Did we update the price on last summer?
I just saw something on
Yes, $2.
Didn't
I saw $2.
Somebody
I put it on this page as $2.50.
I think it was 2 for 2.
I forget.
Yeah, I think it was 2 and 2.
2 something.
Oh, I think it was 150 and 2.
Oh, great. There it is, pizza. Nowadays. 2 for cheese, 250 for pepperoni.
Are you okay with that? I was guessing. I was at work.
That's fine.
I'm like, I think we talked about it. I don't remember. And all I did was raise it $1.
Speaking of that, can I just throw it out there that Supa's Pizza in Dover will deliver to us, and they have 16-inch peaches. So for $2, and they'll give us the pizzas for $8. So if you charge,
were they on Central Avenue?
Down next to Harry's.
Okay. Yeah.
And I can do cheese or pepperoni for $8 for a pizza. So $2 makes sense because they're huge slices of pizza, and then you make back your money on it. You double your money on every cheese pizza, and you'd make one and a half times.
And you said they would deliver. Yeah. There you go, Brittany. That in your cell phone.
I will get the information. Either there or over at Old Rail Pizza. The two best deals. Okay.
Thanks, Jody, for your hard work on that.
Yeah, that's awesome. I don't mind as long as it's not a phone call. Like, if they want to email me, that's fine. Only, you know, because we both work full time every day. So,
okay.
Having my phone blow up is probably not an ideal situation.
Okay. Send myself a note.
And for those of you who, I don't know if they CC'd everybody on their rec, but we're getting people asking when's registration.
Yeah,
we
just.
Which is pretty awesome. People are already look out.
Take the fourth grade. So do you think that we can have this ready by, let me just check. If they can get ready, they can turn that stuff around for you, which they have done pretty quickly. Maybe we can open up registration on the 9th or 10th. It's Friday or Saturday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see. Did you get that?
I didn't get that. I just checked in. I didn't
get it. We're going to open up registration on the 10th, March 10th.
Oh,
awesome.
So I should have packets
to
be done.
I know, but I never get those.
Why is that?
I don't know.
Yes, that one.
You're this person with good
so
notes.
You're not on the rec. She's not on the rec committee list. So if you email something to the rec committee, you have to enter it.
Okay,
I'll send it to you.
Is it Facebook?
Yeah, okay.
Do you want a Facebook coming March 10th?
That way I'll send it to you.
Yes,
that way
you can just
enter
it.
Yeah,
thank you.
Okay. I'll be on Facebook
Power Trail.
Oh, right, yes.
And I just put something out the other day that coming soon.
Yeah. Okay, so Facebook March 10th.
I was just trying not to let them forget about us.
Can I share that to Kristen's page? Is that something that she would be willing to have on there?
Have not.
New Hampshire.
Well, you mean to this part-time?
Yeah, through Facebook. Coming.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. Yeah, once this is set, once this is set to go, that link, we have to push out every place.
Okay.
To Tia, to the town website, to the record question. What Facebook page to
where did that come from?
Our own Facebook
pages.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll
Facebook that it's coming March 10th, and I'll push that out to Rally Moms, the Connection Albany, and so
on. Yep.
And Jody, so I stopped in at the middle school, and with all those lovely flyers that you gave me, and they actually have 500 kids in the middle school, which I had no idea. So what he wanted, and I think you just sent it to me, right? He wanted the e flyer, so that he would just send that out to parents, because I was kind of like, so they have a stack like inside the middle school, the kids can take it or whatever, but I was like, okay, we need to make sure the parents are seeing this.
Oh, so it's not going to each individual classroom?
No.
Oh.
Did you copy on that course?
Well, and I called the school, they were like, oh yeah, we have like 20 per classroom. We have 40 classrooms.
So did you call the middle school? You did call the middle school.
Yeah, you asked me to call the middle school to see how many kids there were. Mm-hmm. There was this.
They said 1,000?
Well, they said there was 500 and something.
Yeah.
And then I figured we have another couple hundred in Zonesworth, and then we have another couple hundred in Noble.
Yeah, so
and then we have the private schools.
It seemed like he wanted to send that to home with each kid. I don't know if that's, they don't normally do that. I don't know. But he was more like, send me the e-file, and I'll send it out to family.
Oh, I thought you said he had said that, yes.
I'll hang a couple up around.
When I stepped in there, he took half my stack, and he's like, I'll take this and put it in the hallway, and he's like, just send me the e-file.
Well, at least it was for the in-house coffee. It was like $40.
Do you want me to take it to someone's room?
But, and you know where else that should go, too, which I have not stepped in, is the high school. The freshman class should get one of those, too.
Yeah.
So, I can make that.
Is Marshwood, like,
so much
where you have to go for the SAT?
I didn't. I just, for Marshwood, I sent the principal an email and asked if this was something that I could come over and talk to him about. And the other one went over there. He looked out, sounds great. So I can get it, probably easier to get this out to parents via email. So somewhere a little more.
That's good. That's fun. Yeah, we still have private schools to do. We still have Summersworth and
I got a couple of over there in
Dover
near my office.
Yeah.
So libraries, we should probably do that too. He was kind of funny about like feeling like we might be stepping on the toes of some of the programs that we're running over. There, like they have a ropes course, a challenge course, and something else, and I was like, yeah, but we're in your school district.
Yeah.
I'm kind of like, same. My students go here. Yeah. So it was kind of a weird.
Their ropes course fills up really fast too. Their stuff fills up super fast. So this would be a good option for all their stuff.
I think if any of us have kids that are, honestly, I feel like the best way is like, all my kids are play sports. I've been talking to their parents. I'm like, hey, I've been handing out things. I'm like, hey, you have a teenager. Hey.
Yeah.
For all of us that have kids in the school, it's like,
they hang stuff up in there.
Yeah.
And then at Boy Scouts, they have like reserve things that would be interesting.
Oh,
is this okay for music?
Yeah, absolutely. You also have the email about the one turning 12.
Yeah, what are our thoughts about that?
We had put it in our minutes in January or February. That they had to be
by March, May,
but first. By May 31st.
Yeah.
So we've already had our first request. That
and she missed the cutoff by 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Yeah. It's June something. So do we want
to change that?
Do you want to back up to the first day of camp, or do you want to just...
I would go back to the director.
We're also, well, and I think you've been here, we also have said that 12-year-olds can, parents can make a choice of sending them to, yes, so they can, 12-year-olds can be a part of this camp, or they can be a part of Camp Raleigh. That was something that we had talked about. Yeah.
Well, in that case, if the kids can technically do both, I would then say, yeah, you can bump it back to the first day of camp if parents can decide between the two camps.
But then she still is qualified.
Yeah, it was like June 14th her birthday was.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Jody.
I didn't get that email. I don't know what her birthday is. But if, was it an email?
Was it a Facebook? I don't even remember anymore.
Right, I think it was a Gmail question.
Okay. Is there anything else that we need to talk about to wrap up?
Can I ask a question about this teen camp? Are they going to be on the premises with the other, with the small kids?
I
know.
In the
same area?
Right now? But I'm guessing Friday mornings they're going to just
be. Friday mornings.
They'll
but
they'll be picked up at camp, so some of them might be in pre-care or whatever.
Okay.
And then leaving for pictures.
We did not.
There is
offer
no pre-care.
There's no pre-care for them?
No.
Okay. Oh,
so just
on
Fridays, they're going to be around the other kids.
Since
so
teen does not
but,
have pre-care.
But in a and different location.
Like,
okay.
Right, so like we know that they're coming in Friday morning, mm-hmm. So the other kids' activities are going to be more isolated and theirs will be more separate.
Okay.
And then so church.
I didn't know that
either. When
did
they
get shirts on here?
When is the, they're going on
church
lunches on Monday.
Oh,
is he going on?
So that's the kids. Yeah.
Obviously, you didn't
talk about it too. Because that's
no,
you
know why?
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So
I don't
have to be here Thursday. Or Friday and Fridays are equal days, so it'll be Thursday.
Lovely.
Unless we can change full day.
That's why we were talking to them about Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
They're locked in for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I already talked to Moira.
And the select board left
so
it up to us whether we want the teenagers to be able to walk or not.
I think that has to be an absolute yes. These are kids who are being left at home alone. So, but I think what we do need to make sure is that the director, and that wouldn't necessarily be you, although you'll
right. assistant or me, whichever one's around.
Right. That, you know, a kid that's supposed to be there that day, we got to make a phone call. There's got to be some sort of, like, your kid's not here and you have signed up for this day. I think we have to do that with the teenagers.
And there was only 15 of them, so it would be easier.
Right.
We are capping that at 15, like that's set?
It's 15 to
20.
Okay.
Yeah, 15 to 20.
I'm sorry, it's a lot, 15 to 24.
And
for the teen
won't let any more than that sign up.
Oh, so they used to go in there too.
So it's a 20 max per week.
Yes.
Yes.
Does anybody else have thoughts about that with the teenagers? I mean, I don't see how we can not let them walk. It's just.
Yeah, I think it's because once they just have to sign out, and the parent has to call if they're not going to come or something.
Right. Yeah, that communication will have to be a little bit better. Just like, hey, you know, you're signed up for this week. Mm-hmm. Where is your child?
Kelly, did you see somebody responded to your Facebook post this afternoon asking if you were hiring?
Oh, I did briefly see that. So yeah,
I responded.
Oh,
I
you did?
Yeah, I just literally.
Yeah, so I was just kind of whispering to Brittany about that. How are we doing with staffing? So we have everyone coming back from last year.
Is that for Jada?
Yep. And so everybody else is and Kara Whitney hasn't responded.
Yeah,
but
I
she
haven't
wanted
heard
to
from
do,
her, but she talked to you.
Right. So I'll just tell her she needs to either touch base with you or respond to the email, right? Jody, you sent her an email.
I just responded in Facebook. I said we're hiring now, forms are online and at Town Hall, 16 plus.
I have another candidate for teen camp director.
Yes, I have to find my
So there's that one person that already sent in their application.
Mm-hmm.
I have a second person who, honestly, she would be awesome. Like, I, this other girl would be great, but I think this, look, she's a teacher in a special ed classroom. She's older, like 28 to 30-ish. She's a triathlete, and she has CPR, first aid, and lifeguard certifications.
But her is the assistant director, and the other one is the counselor.
Yes, that's what I was thinking. So it would be, I might, I want to make sure that she applies, because I don't want the other girl that you have in mind. I think we should still, interview her.
Yeah.
And then ask her, would you be willing to be the number two in case, but.
I haven't seen any other resumes come in.
Do we have an application deadline? I know in South Berwick at the library, they have a posting for their summer camp, and it has a deadline.
Oh, really?
And we haven't advertised or anything for any of these positions. We've just rehired a lot of the staff. So I was just wondering, are we putting anything out there? Did Kathy,
was the whole point of waiting to March 1st, because Al had to respond by March 1st of returning counselors. So now we have an idea of who's coming back, and now we know how much staff we need. That was the beauty of reaching out early. So
I just didn't know if we had a deadline or if it was posted, and whether or not Kathy had heard, or whoever was in charge of the UNH.
UNH, but I thought that we were all set, so I didn't pursue it.
Mm-hmm.
But I can.
I tried pursuing it too, but then we never got back to me.
Yeah.
I tried a couple of times.
Hmm.
But it sounds like we're.
It sounds like we're
full, right?
I'm doing pretty well for staffing.
So maybe we should just hold on.
I have a thought about the counselor to replace. It would be another guy.
Not do that.
One of our neighbors.
I love how you just like round up your family.
He actually asked me at some point in time, are you guys hiring? So he just turned 16.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
You talk to me about
him. He's awesome.
Yeah,
so, I
work there. I love that.
I have a lot of connections in my office too. Like, a lot of talkers.
Do we have any other
business? I don't know what I'm saying.
Yeah,
I do.
It's like kind of funny.
Yeah.
It was asked back in the last couple of meetings about Dick's Sporting Goods. When that letter is complete, we need to put it on to the form. But this is what we have. This is their two levels, donations versus sponsorship. And then it's basically a drop-down menu, except for one section, they ask for a letter, and then they ask, please describe why your opportunity should be considered. So I printed out really, really tiny writing on here, why I think we should be considered, and feel free to wordsmith that however you want, or I can email it to people. And then I did look at Eastern Bank. And their grants, I printed out what grants they offer. As far as I can tell, the only one we qualify for is the neighborhood grant, and it's most commonly given out in $500 donations. So, and I did check into Optimum Bank, and they do give out sponsorships too. So I'm going to continue to pursue that. So, before these can go out, though, they have to go through the select board, and they need a couple of tidying up things, and then they'll go to the select board. I don't know if you guys want to be informed. When I send it to the select board, you want me to send it to the committee, too?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
so the
donation or sponsorship from them.
I put sponsorship.
Yeah.
And then gave them like some things that we'd like to.
Yeah, I saw that in your thing.
This is Eastern
like
Bank.
Eastern Bank soft the soccer goals. Yeah. Those goals are they're not really legal goals anyway. So.
Is there a reason why they're not up? Is it a safety issue? Are the kids climbing it?
No, they take them down for the snow.
Yeah.
And then they just don't come back up.
Okay, so we have them.
The school has them.
Oh, okay.
Because Brittany, get on that.
I see them. So.
I can ask. We'll see.
It'd be great if you get them.
So there's also a bunch of restaurants. Jody had talked to our meeting in January about McDonald's and how they give you money going in. There's a bunch of restaurants in the area that if you give them notice and you work with them, like they usually say 4 to 6 weeks in advance, where they will give you a portion of your profits to go to your organization, and they include Friendly's, Margaritas, 99's, and I have a list of them. And I can shoot that out, and we can decide if we want to do like a restaurant thing as we get closer to summer, or even now, schedule something where people go in. We shoot it out to all of our registered families and say, we're doing a fundraiser, go out to eat, and your profits go back into funding for camp.
Yeah.
So that was another one.
Margaritas,
all right, let's go. And then, in conjunction with the email that Liberty sent out earlier, doing like the glass project and stuff, Doodlebugs, who is here in town, she's doing it either today or next weekend. She does she'll open for a couple of hours, and we bring in invite as many people, sort of like the restaurant thing, as we want, and they can paint, and she'll give us a portion of the profits from that.
Oh, that's great.
And then it supports a local business. And she'll do it for the whole day, so from like 10 to 5, if we pick a day.
You know, Art Stream down by the barbershop, she went to South Berwick Library last year and did some painting, and just like as advertisement. So that might be something, I don't know, you might want to reach out. Maybe we could reach out to them, not to you. Maybe they could do something for like a craft. Even if it's fee-based, like you put it out like, oh, at a week in advance, oh, somebody's gonna be coming. If they wanted to do like, when you paint $5, whatever, you know.
Do we want it to
no,
be fee-based?
We're not doing that.
Oh, okay.
No, we wanted to kind of squash any extra fees for anything. So last year we did anything extra that we did, was grant-based.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And we did Doodlebugs last year, and that was a grant from REF.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we do sponsorship?
So we can do a grant from REF again. I need to contact them.
We can't do that, can we?
What?
Take sponsorships or donations through sports center? We can do that, can we?
I asked her to look into it, and she said she would try.
Oh,
she wasn't sure.
Did we hear back from C&J, Mary James?
We did not. I did write them an email. It was this past week.
Okay.
So I'm giving her a couple more days.
Yeah.
I told her that.
Is Brenda still there? Who's still there? Did you write it to Brenda? Is it Brenda?
Bridget.
Bridget.
I was thinking. I know it started with a B. Wanted to know if it was the same amount, so I wrote to her and said, we found out our t-shirt costs were actually $1,500. And so we're asking for $1,500.
Right.
And so I'm waiting to hear back from her on the C&J.
Right.
So,
Tootie yawning.
Sorry.
Okay.
So,
we're going to try out
today. So, next meeting, do you want to go 3 weeks again? We can do it between March
25th.
March 25th?
That's Palm Sunday.
Next Sunday is Easter Sunday.
Yeah, I'm going to do the 8th.
the PTO thing, will we need to know anything before that? Do we have to leave or anything?
Sounds like they're just running.
Yeah, okay, so we don't, okay. So that's how many weeks away you have?
On Sunday works. In the morning.
The 25th?
All right, that doesn't bother me at all.
25th, is everybody okay with 25th?
Yeah.
Okay, so the 25th.
I just have one more question. Do you want me to keep pushing out meeting minutes to see if we can get them passed at some point?
Yeah.
Yes.
I didn't see any from last meeting. I saw the ones from last year.
I am working on those.
Okay. Can we get them? Within the week that we have the meeting? Because then my memory is a little more refreshed.
Okay.
So, is that possible?
Yeah.
Okay. Because then this way, we give us time to read them. Because if you send them to us today, I'll forget it.
I was just happy you guys were able to look at the letter. And it was not my intention.
I was busy this weekend.
I printed off our New Hampshire State Parks. We talked about this, right? We wanted the five and the 10, correct?
Oh, yes.
Right, I have to hand that in. I can fill it and give it to Karen.
Yes,
Caroline.
As far as money's concerned,
right?
Anything concerning,
five and
concerning
10.
Money, let me know, guys. I need to know. I'm taking it.
Just a reminder, I'm keeping track of finances, so.
So if we do the 5 and the 10, that would be $350 plus a $10 charge, $360.
So tomorrow.
So do we need to, we don't need to break that down, do we?
No, it's just a purchase order for $360.
Okay.
Plus the trip, plus that.
Okay.
You haven't heard anything about the requests that came by email for shirts, did you? I have not seen any funds, so I still got those shirts.
Yeah. I've not seen anything else.
Do you want me to just leave it in the folder for tomorrow night?
But then you fill it out, yeah.
Oh, that was the other thing. We're not going to meet before the select board.
Do you want to
change this over? I went back and I was catching up on minutes and stuff. Liberty is not actually on the appointed list. Do we want to send an email to the select board to help her open it?
Does she want to be appointed?
Do you want to be appointed?
Yes.
To the best committee in Rollinsford?
Yes. So we
yes.
Love that. So fun.
What about Lori Pass?
How many people do
Jody, do I need to do that?
Many.
Or is that something
you
need to do?
I
love you.
Well,
I think it would be good.
Nominations at town meeting.
It's Dan's
Saturday,
right? Okay.
He's
so you can get
he's an alternate.
He's an alternate.
By
Liberty.
Monday the 12th. And if you guys are staying on his chair, somebody's going to say,
you're not the school.
You know,
I'm good with that, yeah.
So are we,
are you ready to work with me?
If at town meeting they can get you guys on, and then the 19th, they'll appoint everybody else. So at town meeting, if you have it all in order, it can just be a town. You guys get appointed to town meeting, and then the select board appoints the rec committee.
So
on the 19th. So send them the list on the 12th, and they're ready to go on the 19th.
Okay.
So.
Clarification. Are you appointing just Liberty or Liberty and Lori?
What does Lori
know? It's up to Lori.
Sure.
And then
is it L-A-U?
L-O-R-I. If they have anybody here anymore.
So
that's a possibility that wouldn't.
That'll something they have to work out.
Yeah.
That's
interesting.
Okay.
And
so
if we add these two in, then for quorum, we're going to need five people, five or six. Because right now.
Then you can put me as an alternate.
Okay.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. here an alternate, but that still means you get to vote.
I still get to vote.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right now, what's...
Unless there's a vote form, and then I don't vote.
Yeah, okay.
So right now, we have it standing that our current members are Jody, Kathy, Dee, Kelly, myself, and our alternates are Deanne, Blythe, and Roxanne. And Denise.
Oh, and speaking of Roxanne, she just
said...
Oh,
then they'll put me in the alternate.
We'll keep you as a full-fledged member?
Yeah, because...
Yeah.
The numbers...
Well, if she becomes the ex officio, we can just swap your places too.
Oh, because the niece is an alternate now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I see.
Roxanne said that, sorry, I've been MIA. Sunday nights aren't good for me. What can I do to help? I can meet up with you or Dee on Wednesday. So.
And if we end up, we could always just have her help.
Should be if we hire somebody, can they be work study in any, or do they have to be work study in the only in the rec department?
Oh, like as a
to get
student,
yes.
Like
does it only have to? Can we only get that work study student in the recreation management major, or can they be any major? Because I know for one,
okay.
This girl is not; she's a nutrition major. So if she was on work study, would that still be?
Can she be on work study?
Or if she is on work study, is that covered even though she's not a recreation management major?
Okay.
And as soon as we get the sponsorship letters taken care of, we'll have
more problems. Yeah, we have the sponsorship letters, you and I can meet.
Yeah.
We can start meeting.
Yeah, and getting rooms out.
Getting donations.
And at some point, if we could set up a meeting, maybe come to the or you can email us activities you want to see, and you can get start getting them set up.
Okay.
No.
She's
going to set them up.
Yeah.
You're as much as we
ideas.
Can.
Yeah, as much as we can.
You're doing it.
That is my job.
We're letting go.
We're good.
Not going to sabotage anything, I promise.
If you need, like, if you decided, like, oh, you're going to do a paint day, if you needed somebody to solicit donations for canvases or something like that,
mm-hmm.
you would tell us, though, right?
Yeah.
Or, okay. I don't know. I mean, if you're, I wasn't really here last year at all.
Yeah.
Well,
so
and
really,
you know,
like,
if
she needs
kinda,
something,
we're kind of relying on you.
She'll come to
okay.
us,
but having
we,
been at the
we're
program, what didn't
like?
Right.
It's gonna be a lot.
Yeah.
She's good. She knows.
Yeah.
Okay. You know better than any of us what worked and what didn't work.
Yeah. Yeah. We did that too. I still have it too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can I make a request? Can I be added to the love blub? Because I feel bad. Jody keeps having to forward me things, and then I miss stuff too when she's too busy. You know.
Is there any reason
we
can't add her to
the
I sent an email to
Suzanne.
Yeah. It's
okay.
It's crazy right now.
I will
so
send it again.
It'll be
okay.
Send it next week.
Yeah, just
yeah,
so ask her.
When we're here on the 13th doing absolutely nothing except for watching people put paper in a machine, that's a good time to get things done. I'll remind her. Send me a text message that day.
What is that, the 13th?
The 13th.
Okay.
Anyone else? Motion to,
What's that saying?
53?
Yeah.
Day 53.
Okay.
I don't know. I never remember. I need like a roadmap.
I don't know.